Okay, so when the email arrives, you just download all attachments, and it's going to download a zip file with all the attachments here. So once that's downloaded, show in folder, you're going to unzip it. Open up that folder, and all the small files that say like 2 kilobytes, or there's big files for each one, so it says 666 kilobytes, and then another one says 2. All the small ones can just be deleted. And I'm going to copy that folder. Okay, so we're going to open the first one of these files, and so it's already laid out on a 12 by 24 sheet. It's a 24 inches wide by 12 inches tall. The layout's already set up. You just want to make sure, well, the first thing you want to make sure is that these antlers, sometimes they put them too close to the edges, and the sheets of plywood are a little bit smaller than 12 by 24 inches. They cut a tiny bit smaller. Sometimes you have to move them in a little bit so it doesn't get cut. So we're going to select all, Control A, and change this outline width to hairline so it will cut. And then go File, Print, select the laser cutter, in this case EPILOG Engraver WinX64 Zing. Preferences, go to Advanced, find Plywood, 1/8 inch Hobby Lobby cut, load, and we should find the settings to be the vector. The job type is going to be vector. The setting speed is going to be, the vector settings is going to be, speed is going to be 50, power 100, frequency 5000, and we have the piece size is 24 by 12 inches, so everything looks good here. You want to have send a laser checked and send a manager checked. So say okay. So to set up the piece of plywood on the laser, we're going to use a vector table in here. So you have to make sure the vector table is set up, because we're going to be cutting through this piece of plywood. So if we were just engraving, we wouldn't have to use a vector table. The plywood, this one's pretty straight, but if it has a curve to it, usually you want to put the bow so the bow is up, so that when the exhaust blower is turned on, it'll pull the bow down. So if you have a piece that's curved badly, you may need to use something to hold down the edges of it, actually, if it's curved really bad or the center. This one is pretty flat, so just for right now, the best thing to do is pick a flat one, and then once you're out of flat ones, to try to figure out how to hold down a curved one if the exhaust's not holding it down. Next thing to do is to turn the laser on. So there's a power switch on the side here. You see that? You turn the laser on, and then we're going to let it start up. The first thing that's going to happen is this gantry is going to home itself. So you just want to let it do that. Don't disturb it while it's doing that. So you notice the gantry moved forward. You have to make sure this table is below this shelf back here. It's lower than the shelf, because if the gantry moves forwards and the table's too high, the gantry can actually hit the table, and you'll have to stop everything, shut it down, move the gantry back, recalibrate, and also move the stuff out of the way. So if your table were too high, you'd want to remove the vector table, then lower the table first. When you go to focus, the gantry moves out, it's not going to collide with anything, and you can use this focusing stick. You put it down, you press focus again, and then you can move up until the material just touches the focusing stick. And you can check all the way across to make sure it's pretty fairly even. Once the laser is set up, and before you start actually lasering, you're going to turn on the fume extraction device, which is this cabinet, the stainless cabinet here. It's got a power switch on the front right here. You see, to push it once, you'll hear the fans start to spin. Before sending a file to the printer, I want to hit print preview to see what it will look like. And what you see on this page is what you will get on the layout of the laser table.
So that looks good. So close this. And now, after we set up all the laser preferences before, so now we just hit OK.
It's going to send the file. Take a look up here. It's going to send the file to the laser. You're going to see the data light is going to flash a little bit. Sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it sends it very quickly. It doesn't flash for long. And then you're going to see a job will show up on this panel. So here we only have one job so far, and the name of the job, which in this case is Untitled. So now that the job is loaded up, the laser is focused at the right height, and the exhaust fan has been turned on. We can start lasering by pressing go. And sometimes this laser's, sometimes you gotta press go a few times for it to start working. But then check that it's cutting properly. There's not too much smoke, looks good. Another thing, we see a little bit of smoke coming up. The smoke can get into the mirrors. So most of the smoke is being pulled back into the fume extractor. But there's a switch underneath here. You can see my hand is. The switch right underneath here can turn on. This turns on a air assist. It's called an air assist blower. And what it does is it blows kind of a sheet of air across it. And so you see it's reducing the smoke. It's gonna keep the lens a little bit cleaner. You're not gonna have to clean the lens as often.